worthy to be praised. You are awesome. You are faithful. Hallelujah. 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 Glory, 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 glory to Jesus. We worship you, Lord. We worship you. Ebu Betika, Okechi, Eku Ebe, Ikukinebe. Praise the Lord. 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 Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Agune chemba Yeshua Amashia. Agune chemba. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Lucy from Dubai, God bless you, darling. You are welcome in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. You are coming here is not by mistake. The Lord brought you here for a purpose, and that purpose shall be established in the name of Jesus. It is well with you. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. The devil is a bastard. Hey, yeah, devil. Praise the Lord. We are not moved by what we see. We are not moved by what we hear. We are moved by the word of God and the promises of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory. Say, I am blessed. I am blessed. I am blessed. I am highly favored. I am blessed. I am blessed. I am blessed. I am highly favored. Hallelujah. 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 Glory, 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 glory. Say, I'm just begin to shout glory, glory. Let me see your comments. Glory, glory. Begin to say glory, 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 glory. We are blessed. Hallelujah. Our children are blessed. Hallelujah. Our family is blessed. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. May your name be praised forever in the mighty name of Jesus. We are blessed. We are blessed. We are blessed. We are blessed. We are highly favored in the name of Jesus. Welcome, everybody. Welcome, everybody. God bless all of you. As you are coming, please share. Help us to share. And may the Lord bless you as you share in Jesus' name. All right, guys, let's share now. Hit the share button. Hit the share button. Hit the share button. Host watch parties. Invite people. Hallelujah. 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 Glory, 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 glory. Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Just begin to worship him. 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 Begin to exalt him. He is worthy to be praised. He is worthy to be lifted. He is the I am that I am, Ancient of Days, Omnipotent God. Hallelujah, unchangeable changer. Father, we worship you, 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 we worship your name. We say, blessed be unto thee. Glory, honor, and adoration be ascribed to you in the name of Jesus. Somebody just worship the Lord. Somebody just worship the King. Somebody worship the giver of life. He is worthy. He is awesome. He is faithful. He is gracious. Hallelujah. 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 Somebody. 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 Karabas kente letela dos kente yadobos yarabas. Reprakatata libaga dos kende yerebos. Hallelujah. Begin to say, Father, we worship you. 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 We honor you. We adore you. We exalt you. Hallelujah. 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 Glory, 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 glory. Somebody shout glory to Jesus. Honor to Jesus. All the praises, all the worship, they are his in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. Yeshua, we thank you. Yeshua, we thank you. Yeshua, we exalt you. We honor you. We adore you. Oh, hallelujah. Lion of Judah, we thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. Hallelujah. 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 Lion of Judah, hallelujah. 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 Glory, glory, glory. Father, we just thank you. We just thank you. We thank you. We thank you. In the name of Jesus. Agune chemba. Hamashiach, Lion of Judah, Agune Chemba. Agune Chemba, Yeshua, Hamashiach. God bless all of you. Agune Chemba. Hamashiach, Lion of Judah. Agune Chemba. I received testimonies today. Praise the Lord. She will share her testimonies. Hallelujah. Maybe we'll do testimony. Phone, you call in. Maybe we'll do phone calling. And you just testify of what God has done for you on the phone before you send the actual one. Praise the Lord. God is so faithful. God is a good God. He never failed those that put their trust in him. He never disappoints those that put their trust in him. That is the God that we serve. He's a mighty, mighty God. He's a mighty, mighty God. We are here to pray, and I want to pray for people. I want to pray for people today on this section. It's a prayer section. Hallelujah. It's a prayer section. I want to pray for you guys. Hallelujah. I'm waiting for Kedibon. I'm waiting for Kedibon because she's the first person I want to pray for. Lion of Judah, Agune Chemba, Yeshua, Hamashiach. In case you don't know, we are fasting for 3 days. So the fasting is already in progress. We started midnight today. Till Thursday, no food. And if possible, no water. Except you cannot stay without that. No water, no food. Makalaraba. We just finished a powerful worship section. Wow, I was supposed to teach, but God led us into worship, and it was awesome. It was powerful. Hallelujah. 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 It was really powerful. Powerful section. Wow. Powerful. 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 God is so good. God is so good. Our Father God is so good. Hallelujah. 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 I am adding you, Kedibon. I'm inviting you. You are at work.
Yes, let me lock my door.
Yes, you are. Yes, sister, rejoice. God bless you. Let me know when you're ready. Are you ready?
Yes.
What do you want me to pray about?
Yeah, I'm not feeling well.
I have to pause the music. Pardon? Come again, please. Thank you, darling. Thank you.
I'm not feeling well today.
You're not feeling well?
No, at all.
What's going on with you? What's going on with you? Did you hear me? Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, I can hear you.
Right. You said you're not feeling well. What happened? Is your phone freezing?
I don't know, woman of God. I was having this headache.
You are what?
No.
What did you say is wrong with you?
I was having the headache. My temperature today was very high. They nearly sent me
to go for COVID test.
I'm working in a medical practice department.
Yeah, that's fine. God will heal you. Do you believe God can heal you?
Amen.
So, is it okay to stand up? Even before now, I wanted to pray for you. I was led to pray for you. So, how is your relationship with God? How is your relationship with God?
It's good.
Okay.
It's good.
Put your right hand on your forehead. Jesus, deliver me 7 times.
Jesus, deliver me.
Fire of the Holy Ghost, set me free 7 times.
Fire of the Holy Ghost, set me free. 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 Fire of the Holy Ghost, set me free.
I release fire, fire from your head to your toe. Fire, 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 everywhere in that room, everywhere in your body. Fire of the Holy Ghost, fire of the Holy Ghost, fire of the Holy Ghost from your head to your toe. Fire of the Holy Ghost from your head to your toe. Fire of the Holy Ghost from your head to your toe. Fire, fire of the Holy Ghost all over you now. On your head, 30 buckets of fire. On your chest, 30 buckets of fire. In your belly, in your veins, in your blood, everywhere, buckets of fire. In the mighty name of Jesus, you powers from the pit of hell, here on assignment to frustrate her life, to steal her peace, to terminate her joy. Fire, 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 fire. Fire, Holy Ghost, locate every power from the pit of hell. Come out in the mighty name of Jesus. Everything that God has not planted in your body is on fire. It's on fire. It's on fire. It's on fire. Spirit husband, fire. Powers from the witches, fire. Powers from any demonic kingdom, fire. Any power from the pit of hell, fire, right now on assignment in your life, in your body. Fire of the Holy Ghost. Fire of the Holy Ghost. Fire of the Holy Ghost. Mrakatatatatatatatata. Epakata latos kente. Ibragadada yikereke. Lande sinte ratosia. Masente kayakate. Rabagadadadadadada. Leketete bakata ranto sinte yarababa. Everything not of God in your body, I command it all out, 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 out by fire, 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 fire. I saturate your body now with the fire of the Holy Ghost. Labragados kentelekete, Holy Spirit, right now, begin to pour fire on our head. Fire on our head. Fire on our head. 20 buckets, one. On any power from the pit of hell, release buckets of fire on their heads. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12 buckets of fire, 13 buckets of fire, 14 buckets of fire, 15 buckets of fire, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Every deposited out that headache. I command you out in the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, whatever is causing your temperature to rise right now, I quench it with the fire of the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus Christ, I command your temperature to be regulated by fire right now. In the name of Jesus. Now, you headache, I command you get out, out, go, go, go right now, never to return. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Lebragados Kandarabas. Look at the blood of Jesus. I pour your blood all over her now. From her head to her toe. 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 La bagadadada yente te 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 te. Rapakute likatos intaya. Epakata lates kente reketes. Ibrogodos kente yadosia. Lagadadadada. Every tree that God has not planted in your body, in your life, I command it to be rooted out of your body now. By fire, in the mighty name of Jesus. Hey, Holy Ghost, pour more fire. Pour more fire. Locate every demon from the pit of hell. Locate every powers from the pit of hell. Here on assignment now, touch all them. 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 Touch all them with your fire. Touch all them with your fire. Touch all them. Now, touch all them. Angels, hit hammer on their heads. In the mighty name of Jesus, hit hammers on their head. Hammer on the head, hammer on the head of any power here on assignment to frustrate her life, terminate her joy, steal her peace, robber of her star, robber of her destiny, robber of her glory. Fire, 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 fire. Wherever they are hiding, locate them and begin to torment them and begin to torture them. Pour your coals of fire on their heads right now in the name of Jesus. All of you, pack your load out. Every deposit, every evil deposit, I command it out, 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 out. Every COVID symptom, die to your roots in the name of Jesus. Every sickness, die to your roots. Headache, die to your roots. High BP, high temperature, die to your roots. Everything God has not planted in your body, I command them to die to their roots. Anything that my Father God has not planted in your life and in your body, I command them out by fire. I send them to hell. Go, 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 go out of her now. In the mighty name of Jesus. I decree your life is restored. Star, destiny, glory restored in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Torture anything out of you in this body. Every snake, every deposit, all of you, get out. Sickness, get out. Failure, get out. Stagnation, out. Depression, out. Everything, every arrow from the pit of hell, I say, get out. At the count of five, I want everything out of your body gone and gone to hell and never to return. One, two, three, four, five. I command you now in the name of Jesus. Go, 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 go. Out, 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 out. Pack all your loads and deposits and get out. Never to return in the name of Jesus. Headache is gone. Temperature gone. Your body temperature right now is regulated by fire in the name of Jesus. Everything out of God in your body, out and be gone in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. It is done. It is settled. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Check your head. Check your body.
The headache is normal.
She said the headache is normal. Thank you, Jesus. Your temperature is normal in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
That headache is gone. And your temperature is gone. Are you feeling any pain in your body? Check your body. You feel brand new.
There's no pain. I just feel the heat.
That one is fire from the that one is fire of the Holy Ghost. You are healed already in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will share your testimony. You go and check your it's the medical center. Go and check your temperature. You will see that it is normal in the name of Jesus. Every COVID symptom is gone. Okay. In the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
You are healed. You are restored.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
So you are the one that we hope
thank
to.
You.
All right. Off it from your side.
Yeah.
You are off it from your side. You can log out. Simple. Who is next? Hallelujah. My hallelujah belongs. I want to pray. If you want me to pray for you, type me so I can invite you. I just want to pray for people. If you want me to pray for you, type me. Hallelujah. The power of God is very strong here. How many of you are sick in your body? The power of God is here to heal you. Lucy. Okay, Lucy, I'm not able to bring you. Your camera, is not showing the video sign. So I don't know if you have updated the Clemens. What are we praying for this time? Lucy, I don't see. I'm trying again. No, it's not going to work. You don't have the video sign. So it means you are using the old. So you need to go on your app store and update your Facebook. Lucy Bell Johnson, go to App Store. Go to your phone App Store. Update your Facebook. If you don't update, if you are using the old version of Facebook, it will not let me bring you on to pray for you. So you have to update. Go and update your phone and come back. Yes, you are healed and your healing is permanent in Jesus' name. That's for sure. I am so God. Brother Clements, I'm inviting you. While I'm doing that, can Sister Lucy, can you please go and update your phone? Mr. Clements, I'm inviting you now. It's actually pray for you. Come and tell me what I'm praying for. I'm inviting you. I'm inviting you again. Lucy, I just told you to update your phone because I'm not able to invite you. But may the Lord answer you in Jesus' name. The Lord. And I pray that you will break through and break forth. Okay. Thank you, Jesus. Libragados kanda yarabash. You are gone. From beginning to the end, there's no place for argument. You are God all by yourself. Oh, you are God If I have no more people to pray for, then we'll just go to the Word of God. From beginning to the end, there's no place for argument. You are God all by yourself. Oh, you are God. If you are on the watch party, if you're on the watch party, understand that I can't see your comments. So you need to find your way to, you need to find your way to the video. Let me see. If you're on the watch party, I can't see. You need to, like, you're on the, some of you are on the watch party. One minute. I'm not seeing your comment, or it's not on the live video. I'm not, but I'm trying to invite somebody, but hallelujah. Sorry, I want to pray for somebody, but Brother Clemens, I was inviting you. You didn't answer. You said I should pray for you, but you didn't tell me what to pray for. Lucy, you said, and let me use this one. You are God. From beginning to the end. I'm trying to read the comments. Lucy, are you born again? Are you a Christian? Say, I am an overstay in Dubai. I need miracle clearance. I want a miracle. Overstay. You already overstayed in Dubai. So you need miracle clearance and you need visa to work here in Dubai. Then you need to go and apply for visa now. You have to go and apply for visa. So that is why I needed you to come online so that I can invite, you can explain more. But I pray that the Lord will settle your case in the name of Jesus. I pray for divine intervention, because that is what you need. Divine intervention. Divine intervention. I'm waiting for Linda. I don't know if you can hear me, or Sister Linda. Brother Clemens, you say pray for me. What am I praying for? You know, I don't like to pray. Leg pain. Jesus, hallelujah, Jesus, I'm inviting you. Oh, Kalabush, oh, Jesus. You got lots of problems, but how do I start the prayer now? If I don't understand what I'm praying for, understand the way I work, I need to know what you want me to pray for. Sister Flaky, I'm inviting you, but you didn't answer. But put your hand under your leg. Put your hand on your leg, wherever you are, Flaky. Sister Flaky, put your hand on your leg. That leg that you said is paining you. And type ready. Let me know when you are ready. Type ready. Sister Flaky, put your hand on your this thing, on your leg. Right now, Flaky, this prayer is for you. I command every pain in that your leg to go right now. In the name of Jesus. I command that pain to be gone. I command that pain to go. I command that pain to go. Pack your load and go. Pack your load and go. Pack your load and go. I release fire on that your leg right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, I release fire on that your leg. I release fire on that your leg. I release fire on that your leg. I command everything causing pain on that leg out. Come out. Get out. 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 Evil deposit in your leg, on your body. I command it out by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Get out. Thank you, Father. I decree and declare that your leg is healed. In Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Check your leg, Flaky. Sister Linda, I'm still waiting for you. I still haven't seen you. Oh, I see you now. Can you leave a comment, Sister Linda? Sister Flaky, check that your leg, it is healed in Jesus' name. Sister Linda, leave a comment so that I will invite you. The Lord is going to touch you. Hallelujah. You are the mighty God. Oh, the great I am. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I can see you now. Oh my God. What is going on with the network? Oh, Sister Linda, I can see you, but there is no button. You don't have. Yes, I see you now, but you don't have the camera sign, Sister Linda. Have you updated your Facebook? Because before you can come on this new face, you need to update. I'm seeing you. I'm trying to invite you, but it's not showing. It's not coming up because you don't have the camera sign. Brother Clements. So please, Sister Linda, can you update? This may be your chance. But yes, you see, it says stomach. Stomach pain. What is in your stomach? Answer the call. Sister Flaky, check your leg. You say you feel good. Is the pain gone? I want to hear the pain is gone. If it's not gone, don't be posh. Tell us it's not gone. We'll pray again. That pain has to go. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Brother Clemens, I'm inviting you. Mashakata. Sister Linda, can you go on your like most of you, like Martha? Martha, you don't have the camera sign. Sister Linda don't have it. Lucy, was it Lucy? Lucy, you don't have it as well. So Lucy, I wanted to pray for you because sometimes All these spirit husbands are responsible for things like that. They want to frustrate your life. So I wanted, hey, praise the Lord. Look at that. God just healed Flaky of pain, of pain on her leg, right leg. I only just prayed for her now. Wow, praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. The healing power of God, the healing virtues is here. Remember in the worship, God said that his healing, his power was released. Hallelujah. Martha, I want to pray for you, but I need to invite you first. Find out some things because you are new. Lead you to Christ if I have to. Praise the Lord. And then we'll pray for restoration. Most of you, how many of you eat in your dream? That is where they do all this havoc. When you eat in your dream, have sex in your dream, that is one way that the devil attacks you. And that is why you need to pray. Sometimes you need repentance and then deliverance and then healing. Praise the Lord. Your healing, Flaky, Sister Flaky, is permanent in Jesus' name. It is permanent in the name of Jesus. All of you that God is healing, make sure you send your testimony. Actually, I will need your video testimony. Do like a small selfie video testimony and send it to me on Messenger. Just short clip, video clip. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, Sister Linda, I really want to pray for you. But can you update your phone? Because you don't have the camera sign. Yes, I can see you, but I've tried now again. It's still not working. You need to update your Facebook. All of you. Okay, go and update, Lucy. Update it. Go on your app store. Everybody, those of you that have not updated your Facebook, go on your app store. Face, you see update. Click Facebook to update Facebook. It will only take a few minutes, and that is when you can come for this kind of broadcast. Praise the Lord. Your healing is permanent. Make sure it's something else you guys don't do. When God heals you, share your testimony and give a thanksgiving offering as a seal. When you get deliverance, when you get healed, or God gives you a testimony, God does something for you, always show appreciation to Him. You are not honoring me. You are honoring the God that did it for you. Always send your testimony and let your testimony accompany your offering, Thanksgiving offering. But you guys don't have that understanding. But I can only say it now and again when I'm led to say it. Because when we say things like that, you think it's because we need your money. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Okay, Lucy, I'm waiting for you, but I may just have to carry on to whatever the Lord wants for us again. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory. Oh, no. Sister Linda, try to update your Facebook, please. There is so much power here right now. The anointing is here. In your presence, anointing breaks the yoke. Brother Clemens, I'm inviting you, but you are not picking your call. You say you have stomach pain. Why are you not picking the call? Why are you not answering? When I come into your presence, I'm so happy. When I come into your presence, I'm so glad. In your presence, there is anointing. Your spirit moves within me. In your presence, anointing breaks the yokes for those that believes. When I come into your presence, I'm so happy. Three of you, Martha, Lucy, and Sister Linda, all three of you, I'm waiting for you guys. When I come into your presence, I'm so glad. In your presence, there is anointing. Your spirit moves within us. In your presence, anointing breaks the yoke. anointing breaks the yoke in God's presence. And that anointing is here to break every yoke in your life. If you want me to pray for anything, let me know. Whether I'm sick, you are sick, you are struggling, whatever. When I come into your presence, hey, I'm so happy. When I come into your presence, I'm so glad. In your presence, there is anointing. Your spirit moves within me. In your presence, anointing breaks the yoke. In your presence, anointing breaks the yoke. In your presence, anointing breaks the yoke. Hey, when I come into your presence, I'm so happy. When I come into your presence, I'm so glad. In your presence there is anointing. Your spirit moves within me. In your presence, anointing breaks the yoke. In your presence, anointing breaks the yoke. Now begin to pray. Ask God to break every yoke. Ask for the presence and the anointing of God to break every negative yoke in your life, to break every evil yoke in your life. Everything that is a yoke, everything that is a burden, anything that is a hindrance in your life, begin to ask for the presence of God. Say, Lord, let your anointing begin to break every yoke in my life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In your presence, anointing breaks the yoke. Hey, are you praying? Lama la da 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 basha. Ask God to intervene in your situation. Ask for divine intervention. Ask the Lord 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 for divine intervention. Rekete te 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 bagada da da. Labasinte rakato. Kente yaraba masente yikatola dosia reprakatata liba katoria rande sikayede la godosia. Hey Father, we break every evil yoke. Oh mashikete lebos, every evil yoke in our lives, every evil yoke maskente lebos around us, every evil yoke of the devil be broken by fire in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Maskente likatatatatata rabagadada ying de lebos kende yaraba reketetetetete kula katala daraba sike yarabosia. Clemens, put your hand in your stomach. You say you have stomach pain. You don't want to come here for me to pray for you. You don't want to hear what I want to say to you. But I will pray for you. I have told you time without number to be holy, to be righteous, to be honest, to be sincere. I have told you time and again, stay away from sin. Avoid sin. Get rid of anything that is sin in your life before the devil destroys you. You need to run to Jesus. Let go of your addictions. Let go of anything that does not glorify God in your life. Because those things, no amount of prayer will stop them. Even when I pray, they will obey. Because they have no choice, but they will always come back after a while when they see that you are not practicing and you are not living in holiness and righteousness. The devil will always come with his evil agenda. I pray for your stomach and I pour the blood in your stomach. Lord, let mercy prevail over judgment. In the name of Jesus, whatever the enemies has put in your stomach, I command them to melt out. Be melted 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 out by fire in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh, ragadada ba shika la la ba 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 ba. Oh, shintelelelele bos kantalaba. Ikaragarabas kentele de bos kantalabas. Oh, skantarabos kente te 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 te. Oh, skenderegede bos sikaya rabas. Ekaradadadarabas kentele bos sikaya dosya. Oh, maskan ta 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 ta. Eh, mashantara des kendele de bos kanta la 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 ba. Oh, skentele te 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 si katala dosi te te. Eh, maskentele te 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 te. Eh, maskanta la tos kanta la ba. I command every pain in your stomach be gone in the name of Jesus. Stomach pain, now hear me, get out. Out, you powers, whatever is causing that pain in your stomach, I command it to go now. Out of him, 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 in the mighty name of Jesus. Mashinte likata tata pakatori arabas. Oh, rikala katala des kandayede. Iprakato leketeri kados kandalabas. Father, we honor you, we worship you, we adore you, we exalt you. We say, may your name be glorified. May your name be glorified. Oh, Mashakataya Rabasinde. You are God. You are God. I decree and declare you are healed in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Check your stomach. That pain is gone if you believe. Hallelujah. The presence of God breaks every evil yoke, breaks every negative yoke. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the mighty name of Jesus. The thing is, you need to have confidence in that power that is in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want us to pray before I go, because we are going to come back again later on with the woman of God. We have a speaker for later. So the message I was supposed to preach this morning, I will preach it maybe tomorrow or later. And also there is a message God is giving me, the names of God. You need to know the names, some of the names of God, the meaning, so that when you are praying, these are the things you use. Mashaka ta 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 ta. E karakate la dosia man sende de debos. E braga da 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 kuraga dos kanda yaraba. You are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be lifted. You are the Lord. You change it not. Riga da da bas konturia. Hallelujah, Jesus. We bless your holy name. Hallelujah, hallelujah. There is a powerful message that I'm going to cover, and we are although we have 3 days, so I'm not in a rush, but right now I just want us to pray briefly and then we take a break. We find out when the woman of God will be free to come online later to continue from where we will stop now. So we'll stop, and some of you go read your Bible, go pray more, go study, go back and watch the videos that we have done for only one day. This is our third video already. In just 24 hours, we started 12 midnight, and we have done 1, 2, 2, and this is the third, 3 videos. So if you missed any of the video, please go back and listen to it in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray. Okay, everybody, maybe you should type your prayer points. Maybe you should type your prayer points. Yes, Lucy, are you online? Lucy, I pray for you. May the mighty hand of God rest upon you. But I don't know if you are a Christian or not, if you are born again or not. That is a problem. I don't know. So that is why I like to invite you, because you are a first timer, so that I can ascertain your spiritual status. And that will determine how fast our prayer will work. Hallelujah. That would, so maybe you will wait when we come back online. We are online for 3 days. Now we are like on 3 days fasting. So those of you that have not joined the fast, make sure you join the fast. And those of you that are watching for the first time, make sure you follow this page on Facebook. This page where I do this broadcast from now, this is where I'm going to be permanently be using for all my broadcasts, English. for all my brokers, for just so we can be stable, because we've been floating from the three platform, from Power and Grace evangelistic platform to my main profile, and then to this one. And I've decided to just use this one, Evangelist Patience Elugbami, for my broadcast henceforth, so that you can share, we can promote and build people to come in. So if you are new, make sure you like this page, Evangelist Patience Elugbami, where this video is being done. When you check, click, tap on the video, you will see my name there. Tap on it, it will bring you to the page. Go and press the like. That finger that do like this is like. And I discovered that some of you, even though you follow, you have not liked this page. I've invited you, but you have not accepted the invitation. So it's telling me you have not liked it. So I saw your names. Please go and like it, because it's easier to just, so you don't have to wait until I share broadcast before you get a notification. So go and like it, everyone listening. Go and check if you have liked it. If you have not liked the page, go and like it, so that when the video comes straight away, you get it. Hallelujah. I like it. When you like, it's automatic, it follows. Lucy say you are born again. Everybody, most people are born again, but are you on fire for God? Are you still living in sin? That's, I need to talk to you. So Lucy, I may suggest, I think when I go offline, message me on Facebook Messenger. On Facebook Messenger, message me. I would like to talk to you, because I don't know what happened that it got to this stage, but God is a restorer. Also, the area God was speaking to me last night was restoration in our lives, maritally, financially. It is a general kind of restoration. And this program here, we are dealing more on marriage, and I'm going to be talking on relationship and marriage. Relationship and marriage, which was our first, was supposed to be our second message, but God changed it to worship. He knows why he wanted us to worship. Sometimes we don't even know why we are worshiping or why God is leading us to worship, until when something happens, say, hey, no wonder, this is why, you know. So Lucy, you are born again. I pray for divine intervention, that God will intervene in your situation, that God will intervene in your case. He will make every crooked path straight in Jesus' name. So I would like to talk to you, and then we'll take it up from there. Relax. Don't be afraid. God knows how to sort things out, especially if you are in his will. But one thing is that if you are not in the will of God, no amount of prayer will help you, no amount of anything, because you are not in his will. So it is advisable to discover from God himself, that is the driver of your destiny, what his plans, what his will. Fake friends, better delete all those fake friends. We don't need them. They are just stress, they are trouble. You don't need any fake friends. Say, pray that for all your fake friends right now. I pray for divine separation. That prayer point is worth praying for everybody. Divine separation from every fake friend around us. Friends, enemies pretending to be fake, enemies pretending to be friends in our lives, even in the lives of our children. Father, separate them from our children. Take them far away from our children. That is when you see your child begins to misbehave at home after meeting with his friends or something, you know. So may the Lord separate us from every fake friends in the name of Jesus, and establish us in his righteousness and in his will, in the name of Jesus. That's a good prayer point. Claire says, oh Lord, let everything that you did not plant in my life be uprooted by fire in the name of Jesus. That is a good prayer point. Everybody should pray it. Look at it and say, Father, pray that prayer and say, oh Lord, let everything that you didn't plant in my life be uprooted by fire. Everything that God has not planted in your destiny, in your life, in your star, in your glory, Father, root them out. Lord, root them out. Father, root them out. Hey, Mashente Lakata Tata. Root them out by fire in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Librogodo Sika Talaba. Ikereketete Bagada Balagados. Ikarakatoto Sinterekete. Librakada Yekete Bagados Kandaraba. Lenge de Sikete. Likatatata Yendalaraba Sikeregerebos Kantaraba. Whatever evil gadget that they are using to monitor your star, your glory, your destiny, and that of our children, we set it on fire, 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 on fire. We set it on fire, we set it on fire, we set it on fire, fire of the Holy Ghost, fire of the Holy Ghost, in the name of Jesus Christ. You are going to pray, anything in my life that is not of God, anything in my body not of God, receive fire, receive fire. Receive fire in the name of Jesus. Receive fire in the name of Jesus. Receive fire. Ekaya kata ta 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 ta. Ekete te 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 te. E mas kanta la ta 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 ta. Ha. That's right. Hallelujah. Hey, Karakata, ta 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 ta. Say, I see myself usually. Stagnation. That is stagnation, no? Sister Mother, they want your life. They want to stagnate your life. Come on. They want to stagnate your life. Say, God forbid. Sister Mother, say, God forbid. That is stagnation. You know the answer. You are not moving forward in that exam. You are not moving to your next level. That is not a good dream. Your enemies are at war. They are trying to frustrate you, frustrate your efforts. I'm inviting you now, Sister Madeleine. You are in the salon, you want to look good. Okay, oh, we'll be online again, no problem. We're online for the 3 days. I hope you are fasting. Huh? He said you don't need their permission. I like the answer, Sister Carol. He says, Sister Flake, he said you don't need their permission to pray them. Remove yourself from their life straight away. You don't need them at all. Fake friends. Don't even try to make them happy. Don't even try to make them happy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Makatalados kenteli arabash. Ikatatatata rabagados kendele lelebos. Iprokotos kenteli katatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatat favor. I'm just guiding somebody on how to reinstall, okay? Hello, Sister Masia, God bless you. It is well with you in Jesus' name. So you have done it, Lucy. Let's try. Because I still am not seeing any. Oh yeah, you did it.
You only needed to update. She has updated, and here we are. Make sure your phone is sideways. Make sure your phone is first on rotation and then sideways. This is rotation. Yeah, go. Make sure your phone rotates. To be in the folder. It says you declined. Put your phone on rotation. Make sure your phone rotates when you like this.
Measure your phone. It's too bright. It's not showing. Okay. Make sure, like you see, when you do your phone. Oh, it's not even working. Make sure your phone rotates. I'm trying to make sure your phone rotates and put it sideways. Go on your setting, type rotation, and then when I call you back now, you just put it sideways and answer. Okay.
I'm inviting you again now. You have the video sign. Put your phone on rotation and be ready to answer like this. Make sure your phone is sideways like that. Sideways. It says you are declining. Okay. So let's begin to pray some prayer points. I wanted to. Where is the person that says she has plenty, plenty problem? Martha, where is she now? Is Martha, Sister Martha, still online or she's gone? Because some people, they just want the prayer. They don't want to hear the word of God. They just want you to solve their problem. They forget that God is the one that solves problem. That they should just connect to Him. So He will solve their problems. So when they come for 2 seconds, they don't get what they want. They just jump out. Wrong. God is the only person that has the power to sort your problem. So when you come on a lively God-ordained ministries or platform or churches, you stay put and wait. Hear the word of God that will build and transform your life. Hallelujah. I don't know what Lucy, is your phone on rotation? Because it's telling me you are declining. So if you are declining, that is you are not answering the call, or instead of you to answer, you turn it off. All right, for those just joining, can you share please? And I'm also praying for people. If you are sick, you want me to pray for you, things are not working, you are facing whatever marital challenge or any challenge, the floor is open. It doesn't matter whether you are here for the first time or not. Many people may come here for the first time, but they are already born again, you know. So invite yourself. Hallelujah. You can type invite me or pray for me. So I'm waiting for two people that are updating their phones, and we are trying to bring them on. But while we are trying to bring them on, we want to pray on marriages. Let us want to intercede for marriages. Marriages in this dispensation and age and time and season is under severe attack, marital attack, every single person. So let me tell you, when you are 30 years old, and you are not married, that is to say that your marital life is under attack. If you are 40 years old, you are not married. 50 years, 60 years, 55, 45, 35, you just name it. You are not married, then it is at least every girl is expected to be married before the age of 30. Before the age of 30, 35, you are expected to marry before the age of 30, 35. That is the prime of childbearing. And that is when you can begin to have your peacefully have your children before you. Medically, they advise you, once you are 50, once you are 40, 45, it's not advisable to have children. But God still passed them all because a 47-year-old woman gave birth to triplets. You see, God is still beating them. And I have one of my followers who is above 45, almost 50 or thereabout. She's pregnant with twins. And we will soon hear her testimony by the grace of God. She has attended my Fruit of the Womb prayers. And God is giving her twins. And we are about to do that Fruit of the Womb prayer again. And some people are there looking. They are not even serious. My own, I just do what God leads me to do. Praise the Lord. So God has beaten medical records because he's the Almighty Father. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. You will hear her testimony when she puts to bed. So that's why I'm not saying anything about it yet. Many other people have come here, attended the Fruit of the Womb prayer. God blesses them with their babies. They give birth and disappear. But we still thank God for those that give birth and they are still here. This is a fruitful ministry. The power of God is in action in this ministry. Nadi, let me not chop my tongue, Biko. You said I should pray for you. What am I praying for?
Inviting you. It's free today. It's open to everybody. I'm inviting people for prayers. And then I want to do general prayer for marriages. Marriages are under attack. Are you not under attack? If you are single at 35, single at 40, whether you are a man or a woman, single at 45, single at 50, single at 55, single at 60, you are under marital attack. So you need prayer. It is not normal. Good morning, Sister Kelechi. God bless you. It is not normal. You say, Nedi, you say, pray for you. I'm inviting you. You are not there now. You are not picking the, you are not answering. Yes, Lucy. Lucy, leave a comment. Let me know if you
had your phone. You are under attack. So that was my message this morning. But I'm still going to divine protection. May the Lord protect you divinely in Jesus' name. As you're going out and you're coming in, may he keep you, cause his face to shine upon you in Jesus' name. And also to connect to that grace and to connect to that divine protection from the divine God. You need to give him your life. You need to live holy and righteous. Stay away from sin. That is the only way you can be protected. No amount of ordinary prayer for a sinful man will work. Because the Bible says it already, that the prayer of a sinner is an abomination. So make sure you are living your life right for God. Here we talk about holiness and righteousness, healings and deliverance. The first thing is your salvation of your souls is much more important. The rest will follow afterwards. And the Lord will bless you. If you're already saved, may he continue to protect and to keep you in the name of Jesus Christ. So as I was saying, we are single at 30. 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60, name it. That is not the plan of God. Singleness is not the plan of God. I think I'm just going to like give a hint, but I am coming back to teach it. Because that was what I was going to teach this morning, but the Holy Ghost did not lead us to teach it. He led us into worshiping him instead. And for us worshiping him the way we did, I know that grounds has been broken. That devil is a liar and a bastard. Praise the Lord. And also, we are fasting for 3 days. Can you see that testimony? We just prayed for her. They were almost going to send her home from work. She said, woman of God, after prayer, my temperature is now normal, as I have decreed it, isn't it? In the morning, my temperature was 38.8. Now it's 34.2. And I feel okay now. The headache is totally gone. Thank you, Jesus. Did you hear that? Power. There is power. Hey, in the name of Jesus. Hey, Kalandos. God is the one that does it. There is power. Hey, in the name of Jesus. To break every chains. Break every chains. Break every chain. To break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain. There is power in the name of Jesus. You just need to believe. You only just need to believe. Ha! Hey, Masca, we just pray like how many minutes? Not up to how many minutes ago. Temperature regulated, headache and temperature, sign of COVID. We cause COVID because she works in the hospital. That is a COVID symptom, a headache, temperature. Not be say they start. Now so COVID they start. It starts like that. They say you are getting headache, you are getting high temperature that defy medications, but you are healed. We cause that symptom to die to its roots in the name of Jesus. Never to arise again by the power of the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus. Ah, I'm so hot right now. So I'm just praying. I don't know. I've been having this encounter lately where whenever I pray, worship, even at work, it's as if somebody poured fire. That is not that inside though. I just begin to feel heat all over me. Hot. Hot, hot, hot. And then suddenly it goes cold. And then whenever again, just as I was praying, at this surge of heat came over me. Power higher, and I want to release it on people today. And nobody wants to come for prayer. Lakatalatosia. You are single. The devil is warring against marriages, and that woman of God said it even in the midnight, that this is one of the agenda of the devil to scatter marriage. You will not tell, like those of you that are divorced. If I ask you now, what caused the divorce? Some of you say, when you think about it, it is like very minor issue. But as at that time, it looked so vast, so big, so mighty. And it cost you your marriage. Are you looking back now, you're saying, oh, if I had known, I would have done this better. I would have done that better. I would not have ended up in divorce. But that same God, the great restorer, he is able to restore. 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 Mashinteletis kayakatosia. Ripakatalekete whatever the enemy has stolen from your life. Whatever the devil stole from you, God is the great restorer. We want to begin to pray for marriages. You are single here. Your days of singleness are over. You are married, but you are struggling in your marriage. Let that struggle be brought, that struggle be brought to an end by the power of the Holy Ghost. Restoration of your marriages. Restoration in the name of Jesus Christ. We serve a God that is the great restorer. We serve a God that is the great restorer. We serve a God that is the great restorer. We serve a mighty God that is the great restorer. Hallelujah. 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 Reprakatala dos kende yarabas. Ikarabas kente de rebos ikaraba. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Igados yaraba. Os kende de rebos in tarabas. Oh, kalalababas kenteletete kukakataladosi yanaba. Father, we worship you. We worship you. Hallelujah, Jesus, we worship you. We worship you, we worship you. We worship you, we worship you, we worship you. Father, we adore you, God. You are God alone. You are God alone. You are God, you change at not. We bless you, Lord. You are holy and forever you are God. We exalt you, Lord, and forever you are God. E karababa baba 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 lige de debo sintaratosi katayarabas. E karabasi kete te 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 te. Oh, Calabas. I'm trying to call this person back because he's our pastor from Zambia. He called me, I don't know, because he was supposed to call me for the land. He went to go check the price for the land. You know, the land we are looking to buy in Zambia to build our shelter. So he was going to check it. I saw his missed call. Yes, so hallelujah. 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 I didn't see his call. Oh. He called not too long ago. It's not too long ago now. Because he was going to check the land for us so that we see how many acres, how many plots or acres we can buy. And the price, how much it will cost us to buy it. So I don't know if that is why he told me he will call me when he gets to the site, the area, so he can show us the area. And I missed his call. My phone was on silent, so I didn't hear him call. Anyway, problem no day. Let me just leave a message for him to call back if necessary. If it's about the land. Honey, we have left a message. Praise the Lord. Praise Jesus. Mashikataladoz kandayadabas. Hallelujah. It is the will of God. God is the one that instituted marriage. The devil has got nothing to do with it. Devil was not there when God was planning marriage. He was the one that saw it in Genesis, that it isn't good for man to be alone. That it is not good for man to be alone. God saw it. That it isn't good. He said, let me make him and help me. Let me make him a helpmeet. And God went to work. And he said, a man will leave his father, leave his mother, and shall cleave to his husband, to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. One flesh. How come after a while? Even look around you. Even Christians are the worst, the most targeted people. Christian marriage is under attack. Christians are under attack. The devil does not want us to live happily. The devil does not want our marriages to work. That is why you must fight for your marriage if you are married. Don't give the devil dissatisfaction. Don't give that bastard devil dissatisfaction. Fight for what is rightfully yours. There are many singles out there. It's okay. Now it's the norm for women to be single and be comfortable with it. And just, oh well, after all, I'm working. It is the trick of the devil. That is not the plan of God for your life. And so you need to stand on the word of God. Father, you created an Adam for me. You created a Boaz for me. Where is he? Oh, you created an Eve for me. You created a Ruth for me. Where is she? You that is currently married, like that woman that just came on just now, I think her name was Martha. She said, pray for the devil is trying to attack my marriage. Just what we are talking about. The devil is on a mission because he knows that God is the one that instituted this marriage. God wants us to be married. Check it. Pastors are divorcing their wives. Pastors. Pastors' wives are divorcing their pastor husband with all the anointing and their knowledge in the word of God, which is why I want to bring out some teachings about that and prepare you for, like the singles now, and prepare you. so that you don't give the devil a chance in your home. You need to get it right from the beginning. Be led by God. If you're already in it, before you got saved, before you got born again, then it is understandable. And so just come for the fear of whatever. You just courted somebody for 2 months. The next thing you are marrying without discovering things about him. These days we are just comfortable with anybody that comes our way. As long as he carries Bible. Is it everybody that carries Bible that is born again? And then you go into this marriage with a mindset that you will marry him and then you will convert him to Christ. When you cannot convert him, when you are the love is sweet. Now that he has succeeded in wooing you and marrying you, which conviction is that one? Please, Biko, tell me. Understand is that the devil is at war. The devil is seriously at war. Fighting our marriages. Fighting our marriages. Fighting our marriages. If I believe, me personally, I am of the opinion that if a man really loves God, because when you love God, you will obey the word of God. If a woman really loves God, if you love God, you will obey the words of God. And as a result, both of you will, in obedience to the word of God, you can coexist, you can live together as husband and wife. I believe that every genuine, me personally, it is my own opinion. Because, listen to this, let me tell you something. We Christians are supposed to have the same character, the character of Christ. Genuine Christians. All over the world, when we see ourselves, we are supposed to know, recognize, and identify ourselves because we will have the same character, and that is the character of Christ. Isn't it? We have the Bible as our manual. The word of God is our manual. Please, everybody that is just coming, can we share this broadcast? Invite people. The word of God is our manual, and it is to guide us. It is to guide us. Sister Flaky and Sister, I'm just hearing this. Sister Flaky and Sister Kedibon, send me your testimony. Send it to me on Facebook Messenger, just how God has healed you right now. Send it to me so that I will post it after the video. You type it on Messenger and send it to me. And then you will still do video one too, because I'm looking for all the testimonies. I want them in video testimony to put on our, we are building a website. So we are creating pages for testimonies. So that would tell people more about what God is doing here. And there is something, you people, when God does something, you are shy, ashamed. Hi, you don't even know what you are doing to yourself. Don't you see where people come on national TV to give a testimony? One girl said she was HIV positive. She was a prostitute. She was a prostitute and was HIV positive on Dr. Paul Eneche Church. That is a national TV. And now she entered the church. God healed her. Now she's not prostituting anymore. God delivered her from prostitution. And now she went for a test, for the HIV test. Lo and behold, God healed her of her HIV status. She didn't care that the world is looking. She was telling everybody that cares to listen. This is how we should do it as children of God. Don't be I don't know, you people, we Christians of this generation, may God deliver us. You are shy to tell people that you were sick, the woman of God prayed for you and God healed you instantly. What is there to be ashamed there? And some of you, many testimonies you have received in this ministry, you have not even shared one. It's so bad. It is an error. Don't be ashamed of God so that God will not be ashamed of you. Say, if you deny me in public, I will also deny you. Share your testimony. Send it to me on Messenger and do a video, a short video of your testimony and send it to me. I will post it as well. Don't be ashamed. God has done it. Give him all the glory. Give him all the praise. It is the Lord's doing. and it is marvelous in our sight. It is always good to appreciate God. One thing you don't know is that when you appreciate God for what he has done, he does more for you. He does more. See this, my daughter, God is my secretary. God is just bombarding her with testimonies. Her testimonies are already fully loaded. The final loading will be on Thursday when she finally goes to work. Her, you know, because of this COVID, she's a nursing professional too. Because of this COVID, let me tafia and do some this thing just to encourage you. She will still share it. So they were all laid off work. Like, oh, now nobody's coming to the hospital because of the COVID. So you will have to go home. We don't know what the status will be, or whether it will bring you back or not. So they were laid off work like that temporarily without knowing what will become of them. And so she had to go to unemployment in the meantime because there's no job. It's not that she doesn't have a job, but she was laid off. Unemployment paid her one, two. The next thing, they seized the money. They didn't pay her again. I say, they will pay you everything they owe. Just believe God. And then she believed the word of God. She trusted, she will say it her own self. She trusted herself, her own self, trusted in God. And now, she messaged me today. Not only was it released, it was released with arrears. Which American people don't do easily. Arrears. They say, they even told her, they were not sure they were going to release it with arrears or anything. No. But they release it with arrears. They backpaid everything. Wah-ah. You cannot be a child of God and suffer. It's not possible. A faithful child, and she's a committed member of this ministry. She does all my work. I can call her now and say, oh, can you write a letter? Send a letter to Zambia for me. Straight away, she goes on she does the paperwork for me. Even people that want to send check in US, she's my contact point. She's so faithful. Always online. Always asking after me. You cannot love me and this ministry and God and devil want to mess you up. They never born that devil. God punish him 1 million times. So God be the glory. And now again, testimony number two. She's been recalled back to work. She has been giving back her own job. I told her when she was fretting over it. I said, Mom, if that's the case, go and apply for that job. And I said, listen to me. I said to her, I said, if your place, your hospital will accept one person back, that one person is going to be you because you are faithful now. I told her, did I not tell you? I said, if your company, if your hospital, if they want to recall anybody and they say, oh, we laid up 10 people, but we need only 2 people or we need one person. I say, you will be the one person. It is not negotiable. I have said it. And because she loves God, she believes and trusts God. And she began to confess it, begin to decree, declare. Now she has been recalled. I told her, do you remember? Did I not tell you? That if your company need one person, it will be you. I have declared it. And I have gone. And God has honored it. That's why I say to you guys sometimes, don't take my declarations, my words, don't take it for granted. Don't be too used to it. Don't be too used to the anointing. The anointing, this girl believes me. This one, I will never start fasting. She's already asking me to pray for a drum of water. She values every word that comes from this mountain. She knows it comes from the throne of God. It comes from the throne of God. Praise the Lord. God is too faithful to fail. Now, I think, and God also did it that. They told her to resume work on Thursday. I said, very good. God wants you to finish these 3 days fast. You have to fast these 3 days fast, and then go back to work on Thursday. He is the great restorer. Ha! And I said, God, oh my God. Sometimes don't think that I am bragging or it's because I want to brag. I am saying it, and I will say it. I know the authority that I carry. I know the power that the Lord has given to me. I know the promises that God has made to faithful followers and faithful members of this ministry. And look at it manifesting. job. Oh, people are losing job in this lockdown. Three of my followers got jobs. Three got jobs. One got job. Was it last week? We were just celebrating online weekend. The other one got job last week. Even better than her previous job. Where they are in this June and July alone. Three jobs. God restored their jobs. God gave them job. That one said, I got a better job. Now I'm even receiving $18 per hour. Better than what I was receiving before. Is God not awesome? My sister has been looking for a job for a while. Since last year, no job. Patient. She was still persistent. She still comes online. Now, God has landed her a job. This one too now, that God, they took the job, restored. I say it is our year of restoration. Everything that the devil took from your life will be restored by fire, by force. Whether the devil likes it or not, restoration. Glory to Jesus. Glory to Jesus. Father, we appreciate you. We appreciate you. You are proving that indeed you are God over all. You are proving that indeed you are the God that controls the affairs of man. We say may your name be praised. We say may your name be lifted. We say may your name be glorified. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All the glory is yours. His glory he will not share with anybody. You are the Lord. That is your name, Baba. You will never share your glory with any man. You will never share your glory with anybody, Baba. Almighty Father, that is your name. Oh, you are the Lord. That is your name, Baba. You will never share your glory with any man. You will never share your glory with anybody. Almighty Father, that is your name. Just give God your heart and allow him take care of you. Surrender your all to him and allow him take care over you. Because he is the one that keepeth Israel. And he neither sleeps, neither does he slumber. He is the Lord Most High. He is the Lord Almighty. He is the Lord of hosts. I am that I am. He is Yahweh, Adonai, Jehovah El Shaddai. Rabagadada lende sikatoli araba. Reketetete sikataladosi araba. Oh, Jesus, I worship you. Oh, we 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 worship you. Hey, Karabas, Kente, Tete, Tete. Oh, Masantalabas, Kende, Yadabash. You are worthy, you are worthy, you are worthy, you are worthy. You are Yahweh. You are Yahweh.
You are
Yahweh.
Hey.
You are Yahweh. Oh, you are Yahweh. Alpha, Omega. You are Yahweh, Alpha, Omega. You just need to love him. You just need to trust him. You just need to believe in him. That is all. So now we want to go pray for your marriage. We want to pray for marriages. We want to pray for marriages. Pray for marriages. I'm not saying for those that are physically married, legally married. I am also addressing the singles. It is the will of God that you get married. It is in the plan of God that you get married. It is the devil that is stealing your marriage. Spirit husbands are stealing your marriage. Powers from the pit of hell are robbing you of your marriage. When you are eating in your dreams, having sex in your dream, these are a sign that you are under demonic attack and influence. They are the ones that want to steal your marriage. But you need to hide yourself, your marriage, your life, everything about you in Christ Jesus. He is the great redeemer. He is the great restorer. He is the great redeemer. He is the great restorer. Now you are going to pray all the singles. Let's pray. We'll pray for the singles and then we'll pray for the married. You that is married. Instead of you, God did not create marriage for enduring. He created marriage for enjoying. Marriage is so blissful. I am a living proof. I am a living proof. When you get married to the right person, and then you are both prayerful and you are handling everything you do in prayers. When you, God is the center of your marriage, how can you, a pastor, pastor's wife, be talking about divorce? Is God the center of your marriage? You will know the word of God. The word of God should condition us to divine fulfillment. The word of God should condition us. The word of God should condition us. That is why I believe that every Christian should have the same character, because it is the character of Christ. But because we are refusing to let go of our old way of life, of ourselves, of our flesh, then that is why you see some supposed Christians behaves abnormally. Abnormally. Then you begin to wonder, are you sure this one is born again? Probably they are not even born again. And you are looking at those non-born again churchgoers and begin to use that to determine how you will serve God. Error in the body of Christ. Error in the body of Christ. Error in the body of Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. May you not endure your marriage. May God grace your marriage with enjoyment and not endurement. Enjoyment. May you enjoy your marriage. May He cause His face to shine upon your marriage. Hallelujah. So now you are going to pray as a single. We start with the singles. Begin to say, Father, according to your word in Genesis, you are the one that instituted marriage. Father, help me. Let my husband locate me. Cause us to locate each other in the name of Jesus. Wherever my spouse is, spouse, whether husband or wife, Father, locate us. Locate us. Locate us. The one that is from you. The one that is from you, O God. Locate us together. Locate us together. Locate us, Father. Oh, Jesus, with your miraculous hand. Lord, help us. Lord, help us. Oh, God, help us. Oh, God, help us. Oh, God, help us. Rakatatatata. Help me to locate my wife. Help my husband to locate me. The Bible says, he that finds a wife, not she that finds a husband. It has gone so bad now that women are the one proposing to the guys. Will you marry me? In fact, they will buy their own ring and bring it and say, don't worry, I've bought the ring. Just, will you marry me? Just they say, yes, I put the ring on my finger. It has gone, women or ladies, has gone that desperate. And then they miss it. He that finds a wife finds favor, obtains favor. Lord, if you are a man, you are to say, Father, according to your word, Help me to locate the bone of my bones and the flesh of my flesh. When Adam saw Eve, he recognized her immediately. This is the bone of my bone, flesh of my flesh. People are quarreling. We are not happy that Adam ate of the fruit. He did not say flesh of my flesh, bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. Are they not two in one? The woman eat giving husband. Is unity in the home? That is sign of unity. We suffer together. We suffer together. And we are one now, one in everything, but not one in sin. No. Not one in sin. Praise the Lord. According to your word, Lord, help me to locate my Eve. Help me to locate my own spouse, my wife. Lord, according to your word in Genesis, help me, Lord Jehovah, cause my husband to locate me wherever he is. Let there be divine supernatural location. Let there be divine supernatural location in the mighty name of Jesus. Hey, Kalalalabask. Rikatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatatat Let him locate me. Help me to locate her. In the name of Jesus. You said, oh God, it is no good for man to be alone. It is not good for man to be alone. It is not good for man to be alone. And he said, let us make him a helpmeet. Let's make him a helpmeet. Let's make him a helpmeet. God saw it, that it is not good for man to be alone. It is not good for woman as well to be alone. Loneliness is not of God. Loneliness is not of God. Yes, I have been praying that prayer, Sister Blessing, for my children from when they were born. From when they were born, I've been praying it. When the time comes for them to be married, I have been praying it. I have been praying it upon my children every day, even in their presence, even till today. I still pray it until they are maritally settled. Continue to up till any time we pray together, I always pray it. And they will say amen. They agree. And that is why God will surely cause it to be so. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Ask God, Father, let my husband locate me. Let me locate my wife. In the name of Jesus, Lord, order our steps. Connect us to God. Let there be a heavenly connection. In the name of Jesus. And trust me, when he comes, you will see him like Adam. You will recognize that this is the bone of my bone. I am the bone of the bone to this man. This is my husband. This is my wife. Father, let there be supernatural location. Let there be supernatural location. Let there be supernatural location in the mighty name of Jesus. You are the Lord Almighty. Wherever he is, Lord, connect me. Connect me to my husband. Connect my husband to me. Connect me to my wife. Connect my wife to me. In the name of Jesus. Before the end of this year, Lord, let there be divine supernatural connection. In the mighty name of Jesus. Ask for the help of God. Say, Lord, I refuse to be single because singleness is not of God. He said, God saw it, that it was not good for man to be alone. Let me bring my Bible. Maybe you need me. Let me get you the scripture in Genesis 2. Genesis chapter 2. Genesis chapter 2. Genesis chapter 2. God saw it. It's not his will. That you are single is not the will of God. It is not the will of God for you to be single. Mm-mm. It says, Genesis 2:7 says, and the Lord formed man of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and the man became a living soul. Hallelujah. The Lord took man and put him in the garden. God made provision for man. Put the man in the garden to dress it and keep it. And in 18, the Lord says, and the Lord said, and the Lord God said, it is not good that the man should be alone. No, it is not good that you should be alone. Remind God of his word. Say, Father, your word says it is not good for man to be alone, which means it is equally not good for woman to be alone. It is not good. That is why he instituted marriage. The Lord God said, it is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him and help meet for him. And out of the ground, the Lord God formed every beast of the field and every fowl of the air and brought them unto Adam to see what he would call them. And Adam called them every living creature. That was the name thereof. And Adam gave names to all cattle and to other fowls and to every beast of the air. While Adam was waiting, he was busy. He wasn't even thinking. In fact, he was the only one. He didn't even know, understand that, oh, he's supposed to be two of him. Jesus, the Bible says, he created them male and female. When God created the dove, he created a male and a female. When God created the tortoise, a male and a female. The dog, male and female. Everything he created, male and female. But man, he started as a man. Just man, just one, no female. But he saw it that this one, loneliness will kill the man. He will talk to animal and talk to animal and talk to animal until he himself will become to behave and act like an animal. And that was not in the plan of God. Praise the Lord. And the Lord went to work and provided Adam with Eve, the God that we serve. It is not his will that you should be alone. It is not at all. So you remind God, Father, you are the one. You said it is not good for man to be alone. It is not good that man should be alone. Karabash kendele. Hallelujah. It is not good. So if you are single, it is not the will of God for you to be single. That is why you need to go to God. God is never too late. I just told you that a sister in this ministry is getting married at the age of 57. She's planning her wedding now. At the age of 57, a sister here is planning her marriage, planning wedding. She's already planning, not that she's already planning it at the age of 57. God is never too late. So I'm encouraging you with this. To know and understand that God is never too late. I refuse to be single. I refuse to be single. I refuse to be single. I refuse to be single, Lord. Father, intervene in my life. Intervene, O God. Intervene, O God. He is the one that saw it, that it is not good for man to be alone. He was the one. He was the one that saw it. So it is not good for you to be alone. So I'll go to God in prayer. God has a way. He was the one that put, he was the one, the same way. Say, Father, the same way you put Adam in the garden to keep it and dress it, put my husband in my garden. You are a garden yourself. Put my husband in my garden. Let him locate me to dress and to keep. Sometimes you see these scriptures, you read it, they are proverbs. Cause my own husband to locate me, his garden, to dress me and keep me. Begin to ask God for his divine help. Lord, help me. Help me because, Lord, I cannot help myself. Wherever my husband is, cause him to locate me. And if you are married, enduring marriage, husband, love your wife. Wife, be submissive to your own husband. It takes love to submit. When you are not rubbing shoulders with your husband, in this dispensation now, wives are the head of the house. They have turned their husbands to wives. Why they that are wives has become husbands? They have turned their husbands to wives and they have become husbands. They are now the head. They are the one taking decisions for the man. They are the one doing usurping the authority rights. This one, you don't know now we are in the 21st century where women are not expected to be quiet, where women, the Bible is older than your 21st centuries. We are not your regular normal Christians. We are not moved by the things of this world. The world is not our manual. The Bible is our manual to both the husband and the wives. We are talking to Christian husbands and Christian wives. Ask God for wisdom. Ask God for his leading. Ask God for his help. He is the only one that can help you build a godly home and raise godly children. God is the only one. Don't forget that whatever thing you are doing in your house, your children are watching. The way you maltreat their father in public, they are watching. They are watching. Because this, your daughters will grow in their husbands' houses and they will treat their father-in-law, mother-in-law negatively, their sisters-in-laws. Why? That is how my mother does it. We are their first role model. Don't you know? You are your daughter's first role model. You are your son's first role model. So if you have not good things, good examples to give them, you have already failed as a parent. May the Lord give us wisdom. Now begin to pray. Lord, even you single, pray in faith, in ahead. Lord, even when I get married, my husband, love, Father, you will love each other, will live in obedience. Pray ahead. Don't wait until when it's almost too late. And you that is married, ask God for his help, his wisdom on how you can tackle and handle whatever is going on in your life, in your home, in your marriage. In the name of Jesus, Father, help us. Oh God, help us. Oh God, help us. Oh God, help us. Oh God, help us. Lord, help us. Father, Lord, help us. Help us. Father, help us in our marital lives. Help us, oh God, with every marital challenge, whether for the single or the married. Help us, oh God. Heal our marriages. Heal our relationships. Heal us, oh God. Heal our hearts. Heal our wounds. Heal our pains. Help us. Teach us, oh God. Show us on how to forgive easily and let go. Help us to be wise as wives. Help us to be wise as husbands. Help us to be wise even as singles in a relationship. Help us to be wise, oh God, in how we are living or want to live our lives, in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you, we bless you, we worship you. Let your name be glorified. Let your name be exalted. Be thou 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 glorified. Be thou exalted in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Just begin to appreciate Him. Just appreciate God. Just thank Him. Just appreciate Him and thank Him. Just appreciate Him and thank Him. Appreciate Him and thank Him. Say, Lord, thank you for how far you have led us today. Thank you for your grace and your mercy. Thank you for your goodness, your grace, and your mercy. Let your name be exalted. Let your name be glorified. Hallelujah. 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 Father, restore. Begin to ask God for restoration. Say, Father, restore everything that I have lost. Restore everything that I have lost. This is also for restoration. We are fasting for restoration. Whatever the devil has taken from your life, there shall be supernatural restoration. Ask the Lord for restoration. Father, restore everything that the devil took from my life. Restore it to God. In the name of Jesus. May your name be praised, O God. May your name be glorified. Father, we thank you for restoration. Restore everything about our lives, our children, everything, family. Restore, O God, in the name of Jesus. Our marital life be restored. Our husbands, our wives, our spouses, let them begin to locate us. Cause us to locate each other, O God, with your mercy, in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We bless you. We glorify your name. We worship. We adore you. May your name be praised forever. In Jesus' mighty name, I cover you all in the blood of Jesus. May the Lord perfect everything that concerns you. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Don't worry. The God we serve is the God of restoration. And He will restore everything that the devil stole from your lives. And the lives of your children, your family, and your loved ones. In the name of Jesus. God bless you all. We'll be back online again today, but I don't know the time yet. I'm supposed to have, our mama is supposed to be online today with us, but she got an emergency invitation. So I will find out when she can come. So with that, I will post an update of when we are coming online again. But in the meantime, we have, this is our third video. If it's that worship alone, it's too powerful. Go and listen. And please remember, you are fasting. You know. Me here talking, I'm very hungry. It's not easy. And this is only day one. I'm already hungry. What will happen when we get to day three? It is where. Also, get your communion ready. Get your communion ready. Get your communion ready. Your anointing oil, waters to be prayed for. Praise the Lord. We'll be back again later tonight. I will post the time. God bless you all. It is well with you. By the time we finish the fast, the Lord of hosts will begin to bring to pass His words and His promises concerning you and your children. No weapon fashioned against us, fashioned against our children, shall prosper in the name of Jesus. It is well with all of us in Jesus' name. Amen. Sister Marcia, you are laughing at your woman of God because I say I'm hungry. Eh? Okay. Oh. So if you don't go and be praying for me, you guys are not talking. I am talking for 4 hours, talking for 3 hours, talking for all the hours. And I will still continue to talk. Eh? It's not easy. I am using power. It is where His grace is enough for us. Oh, God bless all of you. Love you guys. I love you guys. I love you guys. So I will see you guys later. Bye-bye.